If you want to read one book through your entire university degree, this is the book you should be reading. This is like the holy grail of all psychology books. Hello, friends and family. My name is Kappa Bide and I occasionally talk about psychology. I know that some of you that follow me are psychology students just like I am. And I've had some feedback from some of you who are first years. And if you are a first year, then you are in luck. Because I just kind of stumbled onto this book by accident and it ended up being the number one thing that got me through the entire degree, like with no issues. I swear to God, like every time that I was really stressed about a project and I thought like I can't deal with this right now, I'd open this book, look for the chapter that talked about that specific subject, and that would be like basically the entire project made for me, like somewhere in there. So the book that I'm talking about is called Behave, and it's by Robert M. Sapolsky. He is a professor of biology and neuroscience in the University of Stanford, and I've seen him referenced in more than a couple sources. So this book is about the biology of human behavior, and you might think that that's a very broad subject, and you would be right to think that, because that is basically the entire subject of psychology and the biological point of view. This book approaches pretty much everything that you will talk about through your degree. I'd say that it includes pretty much everything in one way or another. And just reading through this book is a very interesting experience, and I think it adds to any psychologist. I think everyone who is studying psychology or is just interested in psychology should read this book. But it's not even just that. Like, if you know how to properly use this book, it will get you through your entire degree. First, I want to talk about the main things that drive people away from this book, and I think those are things that unfortunately are just first glance things that end up not being true. And the first one, let's talk about the elephant in the room. Here's my copy of the book. And before we even talk about it, let's address this. Yes, I know that it's a huge book. And I know that's intimidating. It looks like a Bible. And it is. It kind of is. And I've recommended this book for a few people now. And I don't think anyone ended up reading it. And I think it's for that reason. Like, I know that it's massive. Like, it's a huge book. But I don't think you should approach this book as if you were gonna read it cover to cover in 1 week. This is almost a mashup between a proper manual and a leisure kind of book. Like, when you first open it up, you will see the font and the letter size. It's all very readable. And that's the first thing you should know about this book. It's a very easy to read book, and even though the chapters are not very long, they're very compartmentalized, so it's very easy to grab this book, read it for like 5 minutes and drop it and not stop in the middle of something. Also, it kind of tells a story because it has like an order that makes sense if you want to read it from beginning to end. But if you're doing a specific project and you need to know something about, I don't know, like you go to summary, let's say you want to talk about morality of doing what's right and how to learn what morality is. You see that it's on page 584. You open that page, you see what you're looking for, and that would be fine as well. You can read like chapters out of order and that would still be okay. And also, a lot of the pages that you see here are actually references and not actual text. Like in the end of each chapter, you'll have several pages with the references used for that specific chapter. I've never found a book as rich in references as this one. They're like the main references for the topic at hand. Maybe the best way to show you is to actually demonstrate. I've just opened my university's website. I'm in the curriculum right now. These are the mandatory courses that you have to go through to graduate. So essentially, what isn't included is Introduction to Probability and Statistics and Research Methods in Psychology. But everything else, from obviously neuropsychology, perception, attention, and memory, social psychology one, and there's also social psychology in the second year. Everything that I've learned in social psychology one and two are exemplified here in this book. Not the specific contents, but the main experiments that my professors talked about, they're also referenced here in the book. Second year, so child and adolescence development, that's in there. Emotions, that's in there. Epistemology and history of psychology, some of its contents are in here, like some of the philosophy related things are in the book, although it's not everything because it's a huge course. Thought and language is in the book, adult development's in the book, intelligence, some of the things are in the book. So as you can see, most of the things that you're gonna learn are going to be here in one way or another. It's a very rare thing that, like, with one unique book, you can take as much value as you do with this one. Kid has a lot of scientific background, but it's written as if it was a conversation. He tells you a lot of personal stories and fun facts and, like, even some jokes. And if you're a psychology student, you obviously can't plagiarize the book. You can just take a chapter and, like, stick it on your project, and that will be the work done. But every time you have a project, you'll have, like, a specific context where it's placed at. You could mix and match between what you read here and what your professor said in class, and you'll have a much more interesting project as a result. Also, it makes a world of difference to me when I'm at a class and a professor says something and I recognize it from somewhere. Like, most of the time when you're at a class, you're just, there's so much information and you're trying to absorb everything and you just end up losing a lot. I think that, like, having general knowledge about all of the fields in psychology is a huge asset as well. In any class that you'll be at, you'll be hearing things that you've heard about before. So remember that this is a biology book. Obviously, it doesn't have everything of everything, but it does have a bit of everything. Specifically in the beginning of the degree, if you're in the first year, a lot of your projects you can just take straight from here. Like, again, I'm not telling you to plagiarize what is in here, but, like, if a professor asks you to, like, take two references and use it in relation to something else, just open this book and you'd have 15 different ones and you can pick and choose between those. I must disclaim here that I don't love biology, and oh my god, has this book made that a lot easier for me. Like, this is a great book, and I couldn't recommend this book enough. He does give you a few of his personal opinions throughout the book, and I've had a professor that didn't like that very much. I think that very objective things are harder to remember on by themselves. Sometimes he will tell you, like, two or three facts, and he will complement that with his own opinion about them. And in my own view, that's just a really great way for you to remember all of those things, because there will be a linking point between them. But that is just my opinion, isn't it? So yeah, that's gonna be everything for today's video. I hope you enjoyed this video, and I hope you enjoyed this book. This is not a paid ad. That might have looked like that a couple of times, but it's just because I'm very passionate about this book. Yeah, thank you very much for watching. I have been Kappa Bite, and I occasionally talk about psychology. I will see you guys next week. Bye, guys.